88.1. This is listener-supported public radio. KKJZ Long Beach, Los Angeles, and KKJZ HD1 Long Beach, a service of California State University, Long Beach. Also worldwide at jazzandblues.org.
The music sounds so good here on KJazz 88.1 and worldwide at jazzandblues.org. Steve Tyrell riding home with you today.
Welcome, and I'd like to bring the meeting of the Planning Commission on June 19th to order. Commissioner Klinger will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Acting City Clerk, roll call, please.
Chair Matchin.
Here.
Commissioner Aguilar.
Here.
Commissioner Thomas?
Here.
Commissioner Campbell?
Here.
Commissioner Klinger?
Here.
All present?
Thank you. By motion of the Planning Commission, this is the time to notify the public of any changes to the agenda, rearrange the order of the agenda, and provide an opportunity for any member of the Planning Commission or staff to request an item be removed from the consent calendar for separate attention or action. Are there any changes to the agenda?
No changes.
I have a question. The certification of the FEIR is on the agenda. How far will we go with that? Because
that whole meeting is pushed back a week. It will remain an item on the agenda, and then we'll cover it when we get to that.
But we're not going to take any action on it.
We'll cover that when we get to it, but it is going to remain on the agenda for now. So are there any changes to the consent calendar? All right. Do we have a motion to approve?
So moved.
So moved.
Second.
Please vote.
I'm sorry, can you please verify who seconded and who moved for that?
I think we simultaneously motion, and then I yielded to her, and I seconded.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
There were only two of us, not three.
Okay, has everyone voted? I'm not seeing. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Well, we got greens over here. You're in technical difficulties.
We are having it. Motion passed. At this time, members of the community may address the Planning Commission regarding any items within the subject matter jurisdiction of the Commission. Pursuant to the Brown Act, the Commission cannot discuss or take action on any items not on the agenda unless authorized by law. Those members of the public wishing to speak are asked to come forward to the microphone and state their name for the record. All speakers will be limited to a period of 5 minutes. If you are here to speak to an item on tonight's agenda, please wait for the public hearing for that item so that your testimony can be included in the record and considered at that time. Oral communications are now open.
Significantly less people here tonight. My name is Glenn Duckett. I'm a longtime Rossmoor resident. I'm aware that the formal meeting dealing with the LA Fitness project has been rescheduled to the 27th.
I'm going to interrupt you one moment. I apologize. And ask you to speak at the time of the public hearing if you'd like it to be on record. We need it to be.
I would like it, as I'm about to state, because it was rescheduled, I may not be able to attend that meeting. So if I have a chance to speak in
public, all the more reason to wait, and we will be opening a public hearing tonight for that item. So
You'll want to wait just until we come to that item. It's the next item.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I
thought it was rescheduled.
It has been, but we wanted to make sure that we gave anybody who came tonight the opportunity for the public hearing to speak. Thank you. Is that clear to everyone, whoever wanted to speak to item number 3 tonight?
You'll get your LA chance fitness. In a few minutes, I think is the point.
To be on the record, yes.
Yeah, to be on record. So you'd
right.
be fine.
So oral communications is open at this time for anyone who would like to speak to any to anything else. Seeing none, oral communications are now closed. All right, the consent calendar. Do we have approval? Do we have a motion to approve the minutes from May 15th?
I second.
Didn't we just do that?
Well, no, I'm moving to approve consent agenda, which is.
Oh, okay, all right.
So move to approve.
Second. I second it.
Did you get all of that? Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
All right.
Moved by Commissioner Thomas, seconded by.
All right. Five in favor. Motion passes. And now to scheduled matters. Minor use permit 17-4. May we have a staff report, please?
Thank you, Madam Chair and fellow commissioners. Tonight I will be presenting item 2, which is at 34B Surfside Avenue for minor use permit 17-4 to allow the addition of a covered roof access structure on an existing single family residence in the Surfside Colony in the RLD 9 area. The structure is surrounded by residential units on the southeast and west, and on the north by Pacific Avenue or PCH. They're right next to each other. The home is a three-story single-family residence, and it is in a zone where if they want to allow or add a covered roof access structure that exceeds the height of 35 feet, it's required to go through a minor use permit. The proposed structure is taller than the 35 feet, so it requires approval of this minor use permit. And it can allow a covered roof access structure to exceed the height limit by up to 7 feet. As you can see in the elevations, the covered roof access structure is rather small. It's 4.5 feet wide by about 10 feet long. It slopes down with the stairway, so it minimizes the impact from anywhere around the area. And it's situated on the side of one of the sides of the structure, which is required by code. This covered roof access measures 8'6" from the rooftop, and it will exceed the maximum height by 5 feet, which is under the max of 7 feet. At this point, the staff has received no correspondence regarding this item, and that concludes my presentation. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them.
All right, thank you.
I have a question. So in plain English, it's just a door to get to the roof.
It's a hallway and a door to get to the roof. And the Surfside Colony did approve it.
And because it's an 8 foot or doorway or 8 foot 3 inch doorway, it exceeds by 5 feet, what you're saying?
Okay. That's correct.
Okay. Any other questions of staff?
I do. This building is 35 feet high?
The up to the point of the railing, yes.
35, okay. And it says they're allowed to go 7 feet above that?
That is correct.
Okay. And this proposed covered roof access structure is 8.6 feet?
From the rooftop, yes.
So doesn't it exceed it by 1.5 feet?
No, because the railing right here is at 35 feet. And this rooftop, the actual roofing material that's on the roof or decking is at this point right here. This point is only 5 feet tall.
Okay, so it's down. It's down.
Okay. Correct.
Okay. Is it just the numbers didn't add up right? So, all right.
Any other questions of staff? All right. Then I will open the public hearing. Is the applicant here?
Yes.
Would you like to speak?
I've been fighting rain.
Good evening. Thank you for hearing us. We've been fighting a rainwater leak for 10 years, so this is the final solution to try to stop our living room getting flooded. So that's all, and I've been working with the planner. He's been very helpful and designed this according to the code. So.
Well, can you explain that? I'm sorry. So you've had continuous leaks?
Yes.
And so adding this hallway and doorways is resolving that?
Yes, because it now it's like another roof. It's a stairway going down, and the stairway has many opportunities to let water into your house. By enclosing this with this roof structure and the door at the end.
So the leak was coming through the stairway that was originally there?
It just
okay,
protects
okay, I'm sorry, yes. I misunderstood that. I didn't know if this was a repair or an addition. So well, it's a bowl.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Does anyone have any questions of the applicant while he's here? Thank you. If you have nothing more.
Thank you. No, that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Is there anyone who would like to speak to this item? Seeing none, the public hearing is now closed. And discussion.
I move to approve.
I'll second.
Okay. Anyone want to add anything?
Please vote. We have 5 in favor. Motion passes. Congratulations.
All right.
And Madam Chair, there is a 10-day appeal period from this decision that starts running tomorrow.
Thank you. All right. So, item 3. At this time, I would typically ask for the staff report on agenda item 3 to consider the certification of an environmental impact report and request for conditional use permit 16-7 for the development and operation of a fitness center, but there's a preliminary matter that the commission will first need to address. Prior to this meeting, I was advised by city staff that there was an error regarding the location of this public hearing on the notices that were mailed out. Based on staff's consultation with the city attorney's office, it is my understanding that the staff is recommending that Planning Commission open the public hearing but continue this item to Tuesday, June 27th, 2017, so that all interested parties will have adequate notice of this public hearing and equal opportunity to comment on this item. In addition, in case there are people present here tonight who would not be able to attend the meeting next Tuesday, staff is also recommending that we allow any such persons to present testimony tonight in favor of or against the project and EIR. Once we have received their testimony, staff is recommending that the commission leave the public hearing open, including for public testimony, but continue the hearing to next Tuesday for presentation of the staff report, developer presentation, and additional public testimony for all other persons regarding the proposed EIR and project. Staff, is that your recommendation?
Yes, that's staff's recommendation.
Okay, so if someone speaks tonight, will they be able to speak again on Tuesday?
As set out on the agenda, the city's policy is that a person is only allowed to speak once during a public hearing. Consequently, we recommend that the commission advise all persons present that if they plan on attending the meeting next Tuesday, they should hold off on any public testimony until Tuesday, as they would not be allowed to speak twice on the item, once this week and once next week.
Okay, and then will we need to formally continue this item by motion?
Yes, once everyone who cannot attend next Tuesday presents their testimony tonight, we will need a motion by the commission and a second to continue this item to Tuesday, June 27th, 2017 at 7 p.m. in the City Hall Council Chambers.
Thank you. Okay. Then, at this time, I'm going to start with Commissioner Aguilar, and I'd like each commissioner to state any comments on staff's recommendation that they have at this time. Specifically, do we have a consensus at this point to allow any person who cannot attend next Tuesday to present their testimony now and then continue this item with the public hearing left open to next Tuesday at 7 p.m. in council chambers?
I mean, judging from the attendance this evening, I think it's a fair and adequate decision to make to allow people to speak tonight because of the confusion, and then allow more people to show up on the night of Tuesday, the 27th, to discuss more. But we'd like to hear everybody's testimony tonight, especially if they can't come on that Tuesday. So I'm for it.
Okay, but I thank you, and I want to be clear that if anyone speaks tonight, it's recommended that it be because you expect not to be here or be able to speak next Tuesday. The reason for that is that we want it to be your testimony to count, as it were, and to be able to be considered. Okay, so it needs to be during either tonight or on next Tuesday. And it will be one continuous public hearing that will be left open or continued. Therefore, since we won't be closing it, no one is allowed to speak twice. Just want to make sure everyone is clear on that.
Yeah, I'm cool.
Commissioner Klingel. Is that two O's?
That's fine. And Commissioner Campbell. Thank you. All right. Based on the consensus of the commission at this time, I will open the public hearing and ask any person in the audience who wishes to address the commission on this matter and who would not be able to attend next Tuesday to come up to the podium and present us with your comments at this time. You will be limited to 3 minutes, and you must clearly state your name for the record before you begin. The public hearing is now open.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to be on the record. However, I did prepare 5 minutes, so I'm going to have to speak very quickly. My name is Glenn Duckett. I'm a longtime Rossmore resident. I've been before you before. 5 weeks ago, this commission approved the renovation of the Bay Theater. You did so, I believe, knowing full well that on certain occasions there will be traffic and parking issues associated with activities at that venue, even with the bank valet parking. In that case, I believe you made a calculation that the benefits to that project benefited the community as a whole far more than the drawbacks. Similarly, I believe the proposed LA Fitness project has both benefits and drawbacks, and I think it's probably your plan to try to balance those out and decide whether or not the benefits outweigh the drawbacks. If approved, the developer will make road improvements that will substantially relieve or eliminate the congestion problem at the Sprouts Corner. This will be a significant benefit to the community, the entire community, including those who never set foot inside the health club. Please do not undervalue this benefit to the community. The primary benefit of the facility, however, is that it will be used by hundreds of local residents, myself included, in Rossmore, Los Alamitos, and areas of Seal Beach. This, too, is a tremendous benefit for the entire broader community and should not be undervalued. On the other side of the ledger, the users of the health club will add traffic to the shopping center, but this new source of traffic will be substantially less than the current level of traffic in the area. You have documents that prove that, but it's actually much better if you could see this in action for yourselves. Before you decide, I hope you visit the Bellflower LA Fitness facility to see for yourselves. People use this facility and they trickle in all day long and trickle out all day long. The addition of traffic to the nearby streets will be, at any given time, almost imperceptible.
1 minute.
People going to and from the facility who live in, for example, Rossmore, on their way to or from work will not also be added traffic. They will only be adding that stop to the traffic, to their reason for traveling in the first place. Early morning and late after evening operations of the facility are substantially less than midday operations. I'm not an architect or a planner, but I have suggested in the past that one of the conditions that you impose on the developer is to rotate the facility 90 degrees so that the front faces the back of Sprouts. I have prepared a little drawing using public documents to show that it is possible to do that, and I'll submit it for the record if you're at all interested. I also think that you need to require that they have the parking added at the back of the facility to help alleviate the parking impact on the nearby Rossmore residents.
Time's up.
Therefore, because I believe the broad benefits of this project far outweigh the drawbacks, and the negative effects can be mitigated by these two suggestions, I recommend that you approve this project. Thank you for your program.
Thank you. If you'd like to, yes, you can leave that with the city clerk. Is there anyone else who would like to speak tonight and will not be wanting to speak or able to speak on Tuesday?
Good evening, everyone. My name is Octavio Nuri. I'm a licensed real estate agent that lives in Rossmore. I believe this project is being imposed on our community, and it will negatively impact our real estate values. It will increase crime. It will increase traffic. It will increase potentially dangerous situations for our children, and I think we don't want this in our community. There is a LA Fitness near the racetrack that people can go to. We don't need another one. Why don't you put it in Seal Beach? We don't want it in Rossmore. So that's my statement, and we are opposed to this, and we are not happy about this at all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else who would like to speak to this item? All right. At this time, since no one has requested to speak, do I have a motion to continue this public hearing to Tuesday, June 27th, 2017 at 7 p.m., including allowing additional presentation of public comments at that time?
So moved.
I'll second.
Please vote. We are 5-0 in favor, and the public hearing is continued. Okay. Is there any discussion at this point regarding this? Commissioners? Okay, if there's no further discussion, then we will move on. Do we have a director's report?
Just one quick item for the commission. We have started our summer attire. So from Memorial Day to Labor Day is casual dress, so you can bring out the Hawaiian shirts for the meetings. And that's the only item.
All right. I'll press my mumus and be ready for it. Thank you. Any commission concerns?
I have nothing.
Not at this time.
So we're just confirming that 7 p.m. Tuesday, the 27th, here.
Yes.
Here, B Square. Okay.
All right. Thank you very much, everybody. Meeting is adjourned.
Or is it continued?
And that album's doing great. Quinn is smoking, and he ain't joking. I love using that. People are going to say, man, can you think of anything else?